Hello everyone and welcome back to Eve Market, your weekly look at the Yamaha market. Gonna just start straight off with the look at the market. So let's see, Titanium. Titanium is still slightly going up in price. 5 and 20 they are still moving up and it doesn't seem to start stopping for a while. Still all this discussion about the new refining process and stuff. Everybody think that there can be less minerals in, so it looks like they still think that, and the price is still going up for Titanium. Starting slowly going towards the 6x per unit, but very slowly. Seller's price 5.56. Buyer's price exactly the other way around, 5.565. That went up. 5.42 was last week's price, so it's definitely still increasing. It also seems we're gonna end to it. And there are big orders up, definitely. There's over a billion units, half a billion units, and yeah, don't think there's gonna be an end soon to this price increase for Titanium. Still there's a decent amount on the market, but I don't think there's gonna be an end soon to this. The next one is Ferrite. Ferrite has been going down early this week a little bit, around the middle of the week, and then it recovered again and even starting to crawl up in price. So it has been pretty stable for a while, and now this week it suddenly start changing and moving around. So it went down, went to about 12 ISK, and after that it went again up, even above the normal price it was. Prices 12.70 for the sellers, for the buyers 12.52. Buyers price went slightly down. 12.68 was last week's price. So it's a small decrease in the price there on the buyer's price. I don't think this is gonna keep up long, because there's decent size orders up still. It's gonna take a little time to fulfill, but also not too much, because this amount being sold per day. Just about a billion units per day, so. Then we look at Maxelon. Well, Maxelon is the only one that seems to be very stable. Going slightly up and down, but on average the 5 and 20 days are at the same line. Even with this spike here that's been sold at one day, it's still keeping very, very stable. Seller's price 48.76. And the buyer's price 48.75. There's no margin at all. Still, the buyer's price went down. 49.10 was last week's price, so Exxon is one of those minerals that's dropping in price. And yeah, I don't think it's gonna do a lot, because it's so stable. Let's see, this is already stable for like 3 months already. Let's go for 6 months. No, then it ends up. It's about so this stable for 3 months. But you see there's basically a slight increase in the line, but it's not a lot. Next one is Isogen. Wow, there's been a spike here, and it was Friday. A huge spike in sales on Isogen. It's like at least four and a half times more than normal on Isogen sales here, and you can straight see the 5-day average is straight going up because of this huge sale. But then again, it was already going up for a while slightly, and this was just making a small spike. It's even going slightly down for today's price. 20-day is still slightly crawling up because it was going up already. It's probably gonna keep on going, maybe going slightly down in the beginning of this week, but after that maybe start just crawling back up again. Yeah, start following his normal pattern again. 132.89 for the seller's price. 130.05 for the buyer's price. 131.25 was last week's price, so it went more than an inch down even per unit. That's surprising. Well, the chart say, the price is going up. But someone has probably just bought a load straight off market then. It's pushing this one up. Well, you're better off doing buy orders. Next one is Noxium. Noxium is, still slightly dropping in price. Also here on Friday, a huge sales. Was that with titanium too? No, with ferrite, no. Which one had more? Maxlon did have a little bit of more bigger sales than normal. Oxygen had it too, and Noxium also. Had pretty decent sales. So it went down earlier this week. It was Saturday, Friday, Thursday, and Wednesday. It was pretty low, below the 720. For today, it's sitting clearly above it, around 730 even. 20 days also slightly going down. For today, it's sitting on a flat line. 5 days going slightly up. So it's probably looking for a spot again where it's gonna sit. 746.47 for the seller's price. 723.26 for the buyer's price. Buyer's price definitely went up. Last week's price 715.73. So it's a decent increase in this price. And I don't think it's gonna end soon, because they're getting bigger orders up here. It's gonna stay around this for at least a week. Zandrit. Also here for 2 days, pretty large sales, but not really a huge amount. They have been a little bit more, bigger sales really, I see. There's one here 2 weeks ago even, and it's a little bit higher than average, I must say. At least for the last 2 weeks. Prices seems to start dropping again for Zynrit. This means it's getting even lower than it already was, than Oxygen. But the 5-day says it's dropping. 20-day average is dropping. For day we're sitting higher. I know the buyer's price is dropped because I managed to get some in for my buy order. It was pretty low. So Zynrit has been dropping here in the market, definitely. Seller's price, there's 113 units, not gonna see that. 719 for the seller's price. And 695.37 for the buyer's price. Definitely went down, sitting below the 700 for the Zynrit, that's damn low. Last week's price was 710. And now, I said, I did get in some early this week. I haven't changed this buy order yet. I managed to get some Zynrit in this for this price. For 685 here. Dead low outs got earlier this week even. The Zynrit price. Now suddenly a lot of buy orders starting up. People think, the price is low, so they're buying in. I got here at least like 3.5 million units of Zynrit in. This buy order for this price, so that was for me a good buy. Next one, Megasite. Also, Megasite had a spike here on Friday, but on the rest, it's slightly dropping again. I did have a buy order up that got fulfilled even already, but that one was on top of the list. But it's dropping 5 days, slightly dropping 20 days, also very slightly dropping. Seller's price 1625, buyer's price 1570.22. And you see here still my order up. That went slightly up since last week, $1,545 als last week's prijs. Zo zijn het met Megaside went slightly up in this price. Because it was so low, people starting to set up buy orders and it's starting to increase the price for the buy orders. Morphite. Well, it's basically in the same bouncing price. On average, it's starting to go up in price. And clearly on the 20-day average, that's going up. I'm not going to talk about the 5 days, because that's just bouncing around. Seller's price, just above the 7,000 per unit. Buyer's price, 6,713. That went up. 6,653 was last week's price. So that one is slightly increasing in price. Now let's look at some salvage. Armor plates. At the end of the this week it went very high up. And for today we're seeing a big drop. Just 150. So it's still jumping around. Doesn't know where to go. It drops and then suddenly people signing, oh, let's buy stuff. And it increase. People think, oh, it's expensive. Let's sell some stuff. And it drops again. That's how it seems to keep going on armor plates. 153,333, but it's 22 units. I said always above the 500. 154,000 on the seller's price. On the buyer's price, 147,826 and a bit. That price went down since last week. Was 159,000 last week, so it has gone down with a few thousand. Next one is Burn Logic Circuits. But not so still increasing in price. The 5-day is very rapidly going up. 20-day is still nicely going up at the same line. But it will definitely make a bigger curve in a few days and start increasing in price. 32,900 for the seller's price and 32,640 for the buyer's price. Definitely went up with more than 1,000 per unit, even. 31,253 was last week's price. So that's a big increase, more than 1,000 per unit increase in price for Burn Logic Circuits. Fried Interface Circuits, very clearly going up. Even this week made a huge spike up towards 4,500. Then it dropped again, and for today it's recovered. Well, recovered. It's going up. Just below the 4,500. Looks like 4,450 around there. But Burn Logic Fried Interface Circuits, sorry, is clearly going up for a long while. Here for about a month now. Prices 4,945 for the sellers. 4,401.18 for the buyers. 3,800 last week's price. So it's very rapidly increasing in price. I'm rounding up the numbers a little bit easier. Melted capacitor consoles. I did not expect this line. Definitely not. There's a huge sale, by the way, today. It's very, very rapidly going up in price. It even hits the 4,000 mark today. That's amazing. 20 days also very rapid going up. There's definitely something happening, but there's still a little buy orders up and the price is just not dropping. It's even going up. 4,200 just below it for the seller's price and 4,000 for the buyer's price. Well, It went up for 550 per unit. 3,450 was last week's price. I don't know what there is with this. There's so little buyers up for this, and it just doesn't want to drop it even going up. There are big orders. I agree with that. But it just doesn't drop. It doesn't want to drop. So it's a very, very strong salvage material. That's even its little buy orders that are up here. Even for the whole region, there's 7 more. It just doesn't want to drop in price. It just won't. Power circuits, of well, trip power circuits. Because power circuits are the Tech 2 salvage. Also going up, it's making it up and down. So if you buy it at the right price, you can get it for a little bit lower, and then like a few days later you can sell it already again. It's going up. Not really any spikes for sales. The 5 days going up and down. 20-day average is on a nice line going up. Not really any spectacular things here to see. 64,900 for the seller's price and 61,506 for the buyer's price. Steep increase. 59,853 was last week's price. So there's an increase on his price. Alright, this was this week's look at the MR market. And we'll see you all next week, and fly safe.